that, they can vary the speed of the other three conveyors that feed the primary shredder. All right, bud, if you'd tell me what you're doing.
We're going to open the door to the recording ammeter.
All right, go ahead.
On the shredder, so that we can get a good look at what the current swings are on this operation on December the 8th, showing the magnitude of the low and highs on the current draws. We're trying to process an in-feed rate of between 80 and 100 tons an hour.
What would you say the average is there, bud? You're looking at 100, what's the maximum, 130? Right in there is the average loading. Well, that's 100, your point.
Yeah, I'm trying to get a
130?
No,
let's full load amps.
Full load amps is 130.
Okay.
And there's no place near that for an average.
Under the air connection to the mill, the conveyor belt is actually lifting up off the idlers due to the suction from the air system fan. Thank you.
Okay, Bud, tell me on this side, if you get around here, tell me what we're looking at here.
We're looking at a 680 reversible secondary shredder at the Combustion Engineering Mid-Connecticut project in Hartford. The shredder is powered by a 1,000 horsepower motor and is fed at a design rate to the primary flail mill of 100 tons an hour. It has actually averaged as a feed rate over several 8-hour periods in the range of 90 tons an hour to the primary feed. The secondary shredder typically would see about 50 tons an hour. However, several times it has been measured at operating at 80 tons an hour without any problem with motor current overloads. The shredder is driven at a 900 RPM slip speed, resulting in about an 880 RPM normal operation. The machine was shipped with 6 cage bars, 4 of them at 5x10 and 2 at 8x10 openings. They were subsequently replaced with all 8x10s and have been operating now for the last 6 weeks by cutting out the 5x10 bars at the 5 and 7 o'clock positions, giving about a 14-inch cage bar opening, which has resulted still in a continuation of meeting the product specification on particle size of about 95% minus 4. The boiler feed system has been operating without any problems at all using this fuel being fired into the Combustion Engineering spreader stoker boilers, which are adjacent to this site. They have operated the unit both in the forward and reverse directions with equal success. The impact blocks show evidence of some wear, but mostly gouging caused by tramped metal, which has gotten past the magnets in the front end of the system. These hammers have seen approximately 4,000 tons on each edge, one running in the forward mode, the other in the reverse. Wear has not been as much as was earlier anticipated, and we've exceeded the forecast of 12,000 tons per set or 3,000 tons per edge. That's going to be evidenced by the wear you can see in the video. The shredder initially was shipped with 72 hammers like these. They were later changed to some staggered arrangements, also to 3 rows. We're now operating and find it operates very well by using a hammer in conjunction with spacers between the discs to give us the optimum shredder performance. We've maintained particle size and throughput without causing any overloading on the motor current sensing equipment.
Okay. Show the adjustment.
It's the screw jack arrangement that positions the impact blocks on both sides of the reversible shredder. These are the shims that lock it back from the hammer circle. These are the shims that contain it from moving back any further. We found in this startup testing here that the best performance works with basically a 2-inch adjustment on both the overrunning and downrunning sides.
Okay.
Whether you're running either direction to give you the best particle size.
How much motor horsepower are we looking at here?
1,000 horsepower, 900 RPM, operating at about 875 to 880.
All right.
Combustion Engineering installed a 2-ton jib crane electric hoist to be used in lifting hammers and grates up to the platform
or they can be used as replacement items. The same hoist end is used to lower the used grates and hammers back to the floor elevation.
Tell me what you're seeing, bud. Follow me.